Good morning to you all and happy, happy Saturday. It's lovely to be here with you. I am sitting in my little kitchen where I've got some greenery around me. Quite happy to have those greens with me as they help me to feel like there's something beautiful in my day. And there's lots of beautiful things actually. So I welcome you to this journey session. We're just going to get ourselves sorted. Now, the other day when I did my workout live, the music was too loud. Would someone please just give me a little, hey, can you hear the music? Do you want it a little bit louder? Is it too loud? I do love to have a little bit of soft music playing while I'm doing this. Good morning. How are we? My own journaling session this morning already. I really enjoy just starting my day with a pen in my hand and a coffee in the other one. All right, so for those of you who are here with me, thanks for joining me. We're going to do about 30 minutes to help you journal. Oh, thanks. In case you're curious, musician is same Ludovico. In fact, I've done most writing to Ludovico Einaudi. I've seen him perform a couple of times when we were allowed to be in public spaces together, and he, wow, he brings up all the emotions, all the feels. So we're having a session today about journaling. Actually, I was very surprised. Good morning. Hello, Dolly from New York. Oh my goodness, I'm sorry for sound cutting in and out. I wonder, that's probably Facebook. I have to say, Facebook is very glitchy, and all the things that have been happening with Facebook and all the people on Facebook streaming live at time, and you can imagine right now there's a ton of people doing their fitness videos and etc. It is putting a lot of pressure on the internet. This is the best I can do. The Instagram quality is often much better, so if it's irritating, hearing glitching in and out sound, you might want to try Instagram. However, my name is Tosca Reno. Welcome to my little kitchen where all sorts has been happening in the last almost 3 weeks of quarantine. I have not only been demonstrating loads of recipes that are traditionally based foods to help us boost our nourishment, but I've also been helping you take care of your emotional head heart space, which is a critical pillar of wellness. In fact, the World Health Organization says that wellness isn't possible unless you address all three pillars, meaning that you've got to be thinking about your eating, so your nutrition or eating clean. You've got to be thinking about your exercise, your physical body and movement, because movement is medicine. And also you've got to be thinking about your emotional head heart space. And I would say this latter, particularly right now, is under a huge challenge, just to keep our head on straight and to feel like we can make sense of something that doesn't make very much sense at all, because we can't see it, we can't feel it, we can't touch it, and yet you see all evidence of what the virus is doing to our earth. I invite you to consider that while there are traumatic outcomes from the presence of this virus, there is also something happening. It's a genetic upgrade, and that's proven out and has been proven out with other Spanish flu. When the Spanish flu hit, it was tragic, devastating, and swift, much like the COVID virus. However, it was discovered that those who survived and overcame the flu, and many did, had a lesser chance of ever getting infected by that virus again. That meant that their DNA was upgraded. So we can help our DNA upgrade in the following way. We can take care of our emotional head heart space by doing journaling. Last week's session brought up loads of questions about journaling. Many of you don't like to do it. Many of you think, oh, it's just, you know, I have to write. You think that it's just for writers. I'm going to invite you to consider the following outcome. If you trust me on this, and practice your journaling religiously, you will unfold your hidden creative writing talents. So the book that is lying dormant within you may well come out into the light. The story that you wish to write, the podcast, the blog, anything, this is all inside of you. And when you take the time to commit it to paper, you will actually give your brain an opportunity and your creative self, your subconscious mind, to bring all this out onto paper. So, a lot of times my best done while I'm journaling, and I go back to my journals and discover things that I need to know for my upcoming life. So we're going to run through some journal prompts, why to journal, a little bit of science behind it. I always want to check in and see how you're doing. Hello. And I do love that you're here with me. Hi, Beth and Robin, Karen, Nadia, Shannon, Alex, Fair Denise, Melody. Yes, beautiful. Okay, bear with me with the sound. All right, so here's the thing. Why journal? And I've subtitled this, A Written Legacy for Posterity for You. We rarely have the chance to tell our stories anymore. It used to be that we would write letters and people would gather letters, or we would have a very big thing. From journaling, so no longer do we have a sense of what our posterity or our legacy or our history is. And what I invite you to consider is that writing in your journal may be an opportunity for you to create that. And especially right now, when we're literally in the middle of an historic event globally. So for myself, every day I have been writing about the quarantine experience, what I see around me, how I feel. It's actually incredible for you to have a moment to be able to capture history on paper. So journaling can help you do that. It can create a legacy for your posterity. Also, you frequently have intentions. You have intentions to, you know, get healthy, to exercise, to write that book, to call that friend, to change something about your life. And often we never get there because there are so many distractions in life, and you will find that the thing that distracts you the most, whether it's your phone, your devices, your problems, will steal away your time, and it will steal away your ability to focus on the things you want to accomplish in life. And then guess what happens? They just never happen. So, and I know what that's like because that certainly happened to me before I became a published author. So you want these things to happen in your life, but getting to this wants, your intentions, often doesn't happen. And the longer you put it off, the harder it becomes to actually accomplish it. Now, that's not a very nice outcome, right? We want. But then the harder it is, you give up and you're over it, and that's it. I once heard a great saying by a wonderful leader named Nathan Ricks, who said, I didn't turn off my push notifications. Let me just quickly do that for you. I don't think I can, so bear with me. Anyway, Nathan Ricks once said, the cure for all fears is massive. Cure for all fears is massive action. Maybe somebody can type that in the comments too. Type where you're from, give me a heart, and type any of your learnings. Good morning, Angel. Hi, Michelle, Nana, Shelley. Please go ahead, team. Go ahead and write that down in the comments and let's get a dialogue going. So the cure for all fear is massive action. Get going on that. Closer to your goals. So, but that in itself is very frustrating because there's something called a self gap, right? And that's the space and the person you want to become. And it's a horrible feeling to have that gap because you don't know exactly where you fit and the space feels uncomfortable. Good morning, Nat Harris. Hey, lovely to see you. So the painful side effects of that are exhaustion, depression, bitterness, frustration with life. You think, oh, why am I living this life? There's nothing to it. And it's very easy to feel that way right now when so much about our lives is so different. And yet, as I mentioned in my previous session, I do believe that we are on the brink of, oh, thank you, having your, you know what? Listen, this is my friend Dospirational from Schwerte, Germany. She's having her afternoon coffee with me. And guess what? I'm having my tea, my throat hot. So what I wanted to say is, this is the time for you to try to associate yourself with whatever that gap may be. And I believe that we are in a time of unprecedented creativity. We have been dormant for so long as creative peoples that now, with this enforced quiet, this enforced introspection, this enforced getting to know thyself, listening with your inner ear to who you are, is going to get you in touch with this beautiful part of yourself that you haven't seen in a very long time. Hello, my friend Delphine from Hello. And my friend Maria is working out on her rebounder. That's so cute while she's listening. So the gap, we need to identify, understand that the painful side effects that you might be feeling, or you're feeling incongruent to yourself, is actually your clue. The in there is a secret. And I learned this too. I learned this too because I was living a very unfulfilled life prior to having lost my weight and all the rest of it. I was simply just going through the motions, not really feeling anything, and yet feeling a huge sadness inside of me, like I was a fraudulent life because I was life. And I really, hello Fit Chicks, good morning. And good morning, James Trano from Boston. Hello, Amber. So this is where I've learned to create something very powerful, a keystone habit. It is a singular habit or activity, one habit that you can begin today and write about in your journal, state it on paper so you can name it, own it, say it, call it what it is, and live it and carry it with you every day. And that keystone habit can be something as simple as saying, today I'm going to exercise, or today I'm going to journal. But pick one and make it stick. And you'll find it, this habit, that one thing, will flow a number of other habits because it wants to support itself. Good morning, James. Support itself in your wellness, right? We never want to go backwards. We want to go forward. So once you've identified, yes, that's it, I'm going to eat clean today, or yes, that's it, I'm going to journal today, this is where you begin. You start the writing, and then you find that you gain momentum. Remember, the cure for all of action, and that's what I'm talking about. So create that habit, that keystone habit, from which a number of other good things will flow and support the direction of wellness you wish to be in. Okay. And keystone habits can just be small changes. They don't need to be massive things that have to happen. Hey, good morning, Fitness Cowgirl Audra, my friend from Utah. Hello. Okay, so one habit, like starting to exercise, will spill over or have spillover effects into other areas of life. Say you start exercising or you're going to quit sugar or whatever. Well, you're going to feel better. You're going to eat healthier. You're going to want to keep up with weight loss. You want to keep fitting into those clothes that are one or two sizes less than you used to wear. And then the chain reaction happens, and from that all things flow. Journaling, keep your ears open for this. Now, journaling is a keystone habit. Listen, if you're listening on the replay, it's Tosca Reno here. We're journaling and how it can change your life, keystone habit. And I'd love for you to let me know if it is on replay that you're listening to me, and also where you're listening from. Hey, Jesse, hi. Journaling is a keystone habit. Some call it the most, absolutely most incredible keystone habit, the most productive, the most powerful, the one that have changed. You can commit to it. You will show up in all aspects of your life a better person. You will show up more presently, more mindfully, more cognitively, more strongly, more you, which is an incredible thing. So, okay. So first thing in the morning, here's what we're going to do. We're going to get up first thing in the morning, and you've had a good sleep. You've had hopefully 7 to 8 hours of sleep, maybe more now because nobody's running around. Good morning, Maria. Maybe nobody's running around to their, you know, crazy jobs or commuting or anything, and you're at home. Some of you are. God bless you. God bless you if you're listening and you're a health caregiver. Perhaps if you are a health caregiver, this may be the thing you can do, is start journaling. But that first thing in the morning, take 10 to 30 minutes and empty your brain. You've slept all night and your subconscious mind back here has had time to take full presence in your brain, and your conscious is just away. It's not doing anything, but your subconscious is processing everything that's happened during the day. Your subconscious mind is creating, synthesizing, putting facts and pieces together, creating a new story for you. So when you wake up in the morning and you begin to listen to those thoughts immediately, and I mean immediately, create before you consume. That's my habit, create before you consume. The reason I say this is because once we begin consuming things like our phones, our computers, our devices, our email, our phone calls, all these things that distract us, your subconscious mind is gone. There's no time to empty out that beautiful vault of creative thought that you synthesized overnight. So I invite you to consider setting your clock 10, 15, 30 minutes earlier, if you normally get up at 6 or 5:30, wherever you are, and begin to let your thoughts pour on paper. Last week I said to just vomit everything on paper. There is no need for perfection. What is here is perfection. What is in your mind, what you created, what you synthesized already is your true self, your subconscious mind that now comes to the foreground, and it is a beautiful place for you to place your creativity. By the way, if you're listening and would think that someone else would love to value or benefit from this particular Facebook Live, Instagram Live, please go ahead and tag someone so that they too can. Many successful people, I would say most instead of less, hello Kelsey and Marion, have used journaling as their way to success, from the Steve Jobs, the Einsteins, from Newton, Benjamin Hardy, and very many, Marianne Williamsons, and so on. Journaling is a keystone habit. And here's another thing that I encourage you to think about. We are all creators. We were put on this earth with the Creator, through the Creator, to be creators. Creators, not input. They focus on what they are putting out to the world. Hey, Laura Ann, they're focusing on what is in their minds and their hearts that they've created, which is now coming out to the world. So you want to be a disruptor, and that's what creators do too. Creators disrupt the system. You disrupt your own system. All right, so journaling helps you manifest your goals. It creates, and believe it or not, writing on paper with the pen boosts your cognition by as much as 50%. So what you're synthesizing between your pen, paper, your thoughts, your brain, your subconscious mind is actually coming out in a way that cements in your brain far more powerfully. It's an incredible tool. It really is. So you're getting recovery. You're getting better recovery because you're taking the hamster wheel busyness out of here and putting it on paper and making sense of all this stuff that floats around in your brain, including the situation with the pandemic. It also helps to clarify your emotions. And I don't know about you, but my emotions have been a complete roller coaster. I can wake up and be absolutely positive and enthusiastic and, oh, I've got the world, you know, I'm going to do this and the pandemic doesn't scare me. And then the next thing you know, I can be crashing. So I find it's really important for me to put those emotions somewhere so I can synthesize what they mean. And when I say synthesize, I mean so we can reframe or we can create a better understanding about those emotions. And I've learned a beautiful habit from the psychoanalyst Tara Brach, who guides us in following as we're dealing with our emotions. A powerful thing you can learn for yourself called RAIN. It's an acronym for recognize. Okay. There it is. Acknowledge. So R is for RAIN. A is for acknowledge. Know it. You know what? If it is a day where you are struggling, it's a day where you're struggling. If it's a day where you have grief, then let it be grief. Call it that. Then investigate. The I is for investigate. Okay, why am I feeling this way? Why do I feel grief? Am I feeling lost because I cannot see my grandchildren? I might not see my grandson take his first steps. It might be 3 months before I see these children. What about my mother who's living alone, 84 years old, the time of her life where you'd want to make connections most with elderly people, and you're being told to stay away? Are you feeling grief for the loss of your freedoms of your life? Well, yes, possibly. So investigate those emotions, own them, let them be as they are, and then nurture. Nurture. R-A-I-N. It's a beautiful acronym. If somebody can just type that in the comments, maybe James, I'll give you that job for me. Please write down RAIN. And if you could write down what each letter stands for, that would be awesome. It will help everyone. Don't forget to tag a friend in this Facebook Live. So RAIN. Be with your emotions and put them on paper so they have a place to live instead of eating up your valuable energy and resources in your mind. We are emotional people. And I love this beautiful statement that comes from David Hawken and Bruce Lipton both sort of say the same thing when they say, emotions are the language of the cells. Good morning, Eric the trainer, my dear friend Eric from LA. Hello. One of these days we're going to get our training game on. We have to. We might be doing it remotely, potentially. Let's do that, shall we? But do acknowledge that you are an emotional being and emotions are the language of your cells. Tears actually carry memories because water carries emotion. It's very powerful. Okay, so let's move on and let's think about some of the things that we can ask of ourselves in our journal. I got a lot of questions from my last presentation where people asked about, thanks, Eric, I'll work out with you every day. So a lot of questions were, well, I don't know how to start. And I think sometimes looking at the blank is a frightful thing to be perfect. So I'm going to invite you, your mind and your heart, to the perfect that's already in you. What you lay down with your pen on paper is your perfection. You are a divine person. You were created with the divine, in the spirit of the divine. So what comes from you is the divine. Yes, RAIN was Tara Brach. Yes, exactly, Laura. Thanks for writing that down. Excellent. While you're at it, if you don't mind saying, you know, R is for recognize, A for acknowledge, I for investigate, N for nurture, then the others can go back to the conversation and learn as well. Thank you. Don't forget to send your hearts. Everybody loves hearts. Now I have to go back to my thoughts, which is always hard when I go off track. emotions and your divine self facing the blank piece of paper is perfection already. So don't judge yourself. Please let those judgments go away. Let them fall by the wayside and allow this time with your journal to be your quiet moment. No one will see the journal. It's not for anybody else. It's for you. This is your creation, your legacy. It's also your love. These are your feelings in yourself, having a moment to express itself, which is a beautiful way also to release pent-up frustration, anxiety, and the rest. So here are some, in answer to the question about how to prompt ourselves to journal, we're going to do away with the judgments. Let's not judge. Possibly, we're going to jot down any of the following that resonate with you as journal prompts go. So we're going to talk about the present today because I feel like when we're dealing with what's... Thank you so much, Laura. Wonderful. Thank you. So what really is what's happening in the present day. Very easy to get spun out with the chaos and the fear. Okay, so let's talk about it. Let's do this. Let's start with some journal prompts like, what today is causing you stress? What's causing you stress? Is it something that means that we need to, talk about it with another person? Do we need to spell it out? Do we need to expend energy? Is that what we need to do as we are struggling with whatever reality is happening today? Next question, here's a prompt. How am I feeling? Am I feeling awesome? Am I feeling creative? Am I feeling in touch with my divine self? Do I need to go out in nature and reconnect or ground? Sometimes when you have that spinning feeling, which is a feeling I frequently get, I need to go out in nature. And even if it's a little bit rainy and cloudy, it doesn't matter. just being in the earth, being in the dirt in my garden, walking in nature, hearing the spring peepers coming alive, listening to the trees sway, listening to the water run, that helps to calm me down. Hello, Alicia. Thanks for joining. Thanks also to Beth and Robin. Here's the next question. Write about this. What would make you happy right now? What in all of this madness that's happening would make you happy right now? Would it be just a simple cup of tea? Would it be just a few moments writing what I need to write? Would it be listening to beautiful music? Would it be flowers? Acknowledge what that is and jot it down. Okay, here's another piece. What is it that I might need to get off my chest? What's bugging you? What's irritating you? Rather than having a blow up at the person who parked too close to you with the 6-foot rule or took that last loaf of bread, let's really acknowledge. Let's acknowledge the simple things that matter. The orange that you did get, the cup of tea, the freedom. Hey, my friend Stacy, Nicole, hi everyone, thanks so much for joining. Love you, girl, I love you. Missing Costa Rica too. Here's another thing we can ask ourselves. What is going right in your life? Write that down. There are so many things that are going right in your life. You have technology. You have the ability to join and feed yourself and go out and create a meal or connect new creative ways that are happening right now that I believe will forever change the way we communicate. No, it's not the same as getting a hug, but I think Zoom calls, the pressure on the environment, maybe with reduced traffic, reduced flight, etc. Hey, love you, girl, too, so much, Stacy. You're my girl. These things, when we can see the gifts on the other side, but write them as they are, would be amazing. Right. JC is sharing his beautiful strategy. Thank you, James. I spend twice on Zoom. We call it our virtual course. We're going to be having on Zoom, we're going to be playing game night with the family, and it's just what we do. So what are the things that are going right in your life? Then what do you need to get off your chest? What are you thankful for this moment to connect with you? I'm thankful that I can look at these names and I can begin to recognize you've been here many times over the last 20 years of my life, over the last 3 weeks, maybe brand new. And I feel it's such a beautiful blessing to be able to connect with you during these times because it is new. Because connection, my engagement with others that I've never met is greater, and I feel that very strongly in my heart. Okay, another prompt is, what are you passionate about? What gets the blood stirring? What makes your kundalini rise? What is the thing that you want to do that just fires up your soul? Maybe it's painting paintings. Maybe it's getting out the guitar, the dusty in the back of your cupboard, and playing to your heartstrings again. Maybe it's writing that book, that beautiful story, the autobiography that's been living inside of you. Maybe it's time. Maybe it's time for that passion to come out and just make that passion bloom because we have the opportunity now. All right, what other prompts could we have? How about your values? Do you understand what your values are? And if so, is there a way that you could live more deeply aligned with your values? What do you think? We could ask that question. How do you relax? Do you practice meditation? Do you do any of those things to bring relaxation into your beautiful soul? Ask yourself, what are the small things? What are the small, beautiful things in life? What gives you a sense of satisfaction? These are all journal prompts. And here's another. Here's your homework. Part of happiness is this moment that we spend together also. And we can acknowledge that a cup of tea brings us happiness, that my technology that gives me the music and the sound of Mr. Einaudi, whom I dearly love. We can acknowledge all these things. Do you savor them? Do you put them on the back of your tongue and let the flavors of them settle into your cells? Do you feel it? Into your soul. Savoring. We so quickly move from one thing to the next without actually feeling what that joy is all about. I've been blessed to spend a week with my daughter, and I have savored every moment. it's new for me. Yes, of course, the rhythms are new, but the walks, the workouts, the coffees, the way she cooks, the way she taught me how to make sourdough bread. Do we savor these things? Hi, Kirsten. Good morning. My daughter's on too. Ask yourself when a happy moment happens, when you've given birth to your sourdough baby. Do you savor that moment? Do you put it in your heart and acknowledge that so much about the happiness that we feel here, the language of our soul? So I invite you to take this journaling experience deeply into your day, into your life. I'm going to be coming back to you with another such session later in the coming weeks, because I've been into this for a few months. I invite you to write your comments. I invite you to empty your soul, share it with us, because whatever thought you're thinking is your unique thought, but many are thinking the same. So sharing it here builds a beautiful. I also welcome you to share this live broadcast with anyone that you feel would greatly benefit from it. I share my love and my blessings with you. Please make sure you go visit toscareno.com, where I have put up a resource page, because I feel now more than ever compelled, driven to serve you. So I've completely reduced all my pricing. It's not a sales pitch. I really want you to get well, because your wellness is my passion. So go to toscareno.com and have a beautiful, beautiful Saturday. I'm going to savor this moment for a few minutes with you. Thank you for bringing me into your homes and your hearts. God bless and be well.